We have wanted solar on our property for a really long time, and so now we have finally come to that time.
And it's exciting. So what we want to do in this video is kind of give you a primer, show you the stuff that we have been spending some time amassing, getting supplies together, tools, and other things, and basically just introduce you to the project, maybe what we hope it will do, where the components are going to go, and otherwise sharing our excitement as we start to take this somewhat large endeavor and project, but something that we think is going to be really fun and beneficial too.
With the solar setup, one of the first things you need is solar panels. So we had a couple of them, about 10 to 20, that were old, used ones that we had bought. And those may still get used like for Sam's workshop or something, but we realized that those would not be enough to run our house off of. So we needed new ones or new used ones. Well, Sam, in his investigative skills, went looking on Facebook Marketplace and found a really good deal. So he went to Middle Tennessee at a warehouse that had them almost like clearanced out, and we got 36 to run our house with.
So the solar panels we got are brand new. They are a tier one class solar panel, which just basically means good quality. And we purchased them from, like Angel said, off Facebook Marketplace, but this person imports them from manufacturers and sells them by the hundreds. The price per panel was also the cheapest that we could find anywhere else, even while searching the exact same solar panels from other resellers, and was just a great deal. The second big consideration with your solar system or off-grid system is your inverter and battery selections. We live in a single-wide mobile home. We're a family of four, working, homeschooling, living, all in that space. And it means there's no extra space for stuff like this. We are going to be installing it in a storage building, which might just be where we are right now, and show you guys another option or a different way to think outside of the box as far as where to put an off-grid system and how to wire it all up. Our next video in this series is going to be specifically about the Lux Power Inverter and the Big Battery brand Ethos battery system. It's going to be technical. It's going to be one of those where you may glaze over a little bit if you don't love details, but it's all a part of also sharing the entire story, start to finish, all of the steps, and better educating you guys on what all it takes to do this kind of a system.
With this project, there is going to be a lot of digging. A lot of digging being about 500 feet of trenching, plus a lot of footers for the solar panel array. It just so happened we were blessed enough to get an email from a company wanting to see if we wanted to try out a mini excavator. So you will see this thing put to use digging some trenches and some footers pretty soon. There will also be a video coming up showcasing this new mini excavator and telling you all about it as well. Welcome to the driveway in the front of our house. We are going to have our array, which is where all your solar panels are set up, at the end of the house in the field back there. We are on 15 acres, so we do have plenty of room here to put it. You may ask, well, why not put it on the top of our house? Because our house is southern facing. It would be hard to get up to clean them off, and it opens up another area to leak later on, which is something that we really don't want to do.
Absolutely not. It is very important to keep your solar panels clean, because depending on the dirtiness or cleanliness depends on your performance. We're also really lucky to have pure southern facing exposure. Actually, when the house was set here on the property beforehand, we had some flags and stakes put out. We aligned it perfectly south. It's one of the things that I've kind of been picky over, maybe because I always dreamed of solar someday. Of course, now that we do this project, it doesn't matter how the structure is laid out because we're doing ground mount. But hey, it all at least lines pretty for Google Maps, I guess. We will be building a ground mount array. What that means is we'll be putting posts in the ground, building beams, and the solar panels will be freestanding. It's going to be a structure. We get very high winds out here. We get winds regularly gusting 60 miles per hour plus in the spring and fall weather times. So whatever we build is going to have to be legitimate, going to have to be very strong, built properly, and just not become a giant sail. Because the last thing we want is to spend all of this money, all of the time, to literally have it blow away in the storm.
So there's the overview of what we have coming up in the next couple of weeks.
Hopefully you guys don't take a video like this as if we're bragging or saying, hey, look at us. We've got the mini excavator. We've got this and that and the other. Just know that any excitement and stuff that we portray and show is just genuine excitement that we've been blessed enough through this YouTube channel and through other means to be able to even get to do something like this. And then I get excited over getting to show and tell and help teach stuff. So please don't take it as, look at us, we're so awesome, we have all this great stuff, because it's not our doing.
Well guys, thanks for coming along as we gave you the overview of our solar project to come. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Otherwise, we'll see you guys next time on the homestead.
Let's get to work.
See ya.
Hello everybody, my name's Sam.
Yeah.
You gonna be able to see okay?
Yeah.
I don't see how you don't wear sunglasses outside. It's weird.
I like light.
Man, I get tired of our same intro, but it's like, it's what we do.
Okay.
Okay. This is a little bit of a sneak peek, but there is a inverter, blah, blah, blah. Depending on the dirtiness or cleanliness, depends on your performance. You didn't leave me much to say. You really covered all that really well. That videos will start flowing on pretty much, I think, after this one. And it's something that is
going to be a series of videos.
Yeah.
It's going to be a series.
Next video in this solar project series is going to be a... All of the stuff we need to hopefully take our house off-grid. The majority of it, at least. That was short. Then, there you go. That's everything we're talking about. From a company called Big Battery, but wanted to give this to you as, oh my gosh.
Let's go.
On what all it takes to do this kind of a system.
Yay!
I did that! Wow! It only took 4 times off camera. I guess give you a heads up. A
preemptive.
Yeah, we're so good with words.
So we are going to be adding in all the necessary equipment and running all the necessary lines and building the necessary
necessities.